Now, with our deepest respect, Mr. Counsellor Tian Xiaogang will give his opening address on behalf of the Chinese Embassy in the UK. Let's all welcome.
Thank you to come to this place and to make a short remark on behalf of the Ministry of the Embassy, especially the section of education. Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends and dear students, dear professors, I feel excited. You know, just about exactly a month ago, I was here on this campus. I didn't expect I would return immediately. You know, last month I was here with the ambassador. That's on the 22nd of February. And today, again, it is March, also the 22nd. So I feel excited. I think it is not only just because I'm interested in this event, it is a kind of luck. Certainly last time I was one of the delegation of the ambassador, so I attended his presentation as one of you sitting there listening. And this time, I'm one of the speakers. I feel greatly honored. No matter whether I'm a speaker or an audience, I feel that the uniqueness of this university and also of the college, a kind of atmosphere, a trend of making you to feel enjoying your study here in this environment and make you feel that it is the right place to do all the research and also the right place to have your development of your spirit of entrepreneurship. So I believe that is the reason for the host to pick up this particular site, the university and the college, as the master just mentioned. It's the one with every reason to be here. So my congratulations for the opening ceremony for the high-level entrepreneurship challenge. The embassy would like to congratulate the host, that's CSSA, and the other delegates who are contributing for organizing this particular event. And certainly there will be a long month to come for the competition. So I know it is a job that requires a lot of effort and a lot of time you have to spend on that. So my best regards for every one of you who have made contributions. Actually, the 25th of March would mark the third anniversary of my working in the Chinese Embassy in UK as Minister Counselor. So I feel that in the past 3 years, my most biggest impression is that the work at embassy getting busier and busier every year. And some of my colleagues in the embassy had a summary saying that people are working in the embassy 5+2, means from Monday to Friday, then plus Sunday and Saturday. And from, they call them day and the night. Yeah. So I think that's very true. The life of the diplomats in the embassy is not something as other people would imagine as such a place where you make all the speeches, but a lot of hard work you have to do in the office, handling about 100,000 Chinese students studying in the UK nowadays on different campuses. So even just pick up the telephone calls, you can imagine, and answering the email, that will keep every one of us so busy. However, I feel that in the past 3 years, the gigantic change of the educational exchanges and cooperation between China attend the UK, especially at the university level, I feel that the high growth or development will represent the good relationship between the two countries. And despite you have tightened your visa for students coming to study in this university, in this university in this country, we have seen the number of students coming is still growing. So I feel I can find some pleasure within very tight schedule every day. You will have to travel, have to visit different universities and going to schools, talking about language, talking about educational exchanges. So I'm so glad to see more and more people interested in China and also in Chinese language. I'm glad to hear what you have just said. That's a perfect Mandarin, I would say. So I hope that 讲得非常好, 很地道. I feel that Chinese students, of them been studying very hard and working very hard as well. They are doing a lot of research and trying to get the highest marks possible for their examinations. At the same time, they want to devote their energy to help others. I think this is one of the examples and the spirit of the Chinese Student and Scholar Association. Students involved in it gave their time for others to make their life easier and to make their career more successful. Chinese Premier Wen Jiabao just had a very important speech. They called the government report last week to the 11th People's Congress, that's the Chinese Parliament. And he mentioned, I would like to quote, that focusing on high level and high skilled staff personnel, we wish to see a big number of scientists or technicians with innovative ideas or innovative thinking. And we wish to have more talent people that government feels short of. So this is what the government is hoping. And I believe here in the United Kingdom, among the 100,000 Chinese students and scholars, we do have a lot of talented people. In order to attract them to work and to contribute to the Chinese development, so the government have developed several plans. For instance, the project for 1,000 talent project, that is specially designed for those who are now working or studying overseas and for you to contribute to the development at home in China. Certainly, that's the project at the central government level. Different municipal governments also developed their own competent or they called the talent programs. It could be for people of my age or it could be people for the students who are sitting here that in their late 20s. So the government expects that they will be able to become the backbones of the future development, not only for China. I think with their experience after studying in the UK, their contribution will be two ways, to help China as well at the same time help the United Kingdom, not only just for the intellectuals, but also for to benefit the other sectors in the society. So I would like to re-stress that this particular challenge is a well received idea and being strongly supported by the Education Embassy, the Embassy of China here, especially the education section. And we wish that this will become a very good start and will serve more students at different levels. Today we have the title called High Level, and maybe we could even go to mid level or lower level. But that means the skills or the talents, the knowledge. We're talking about the age. We could coming down to the younger people with innovative ideas. I must confess that is one of the weakness in our education system. Students do not have enough innovative ideas or ways of thinking innovatively. So I would like to compliment the host for picking up these subjects, and also I sincerely wish that this competition, this challenge, will be a full success. Especially, you know, just about a month ago, I heard a lot of complaints or worries from Chinese students about the possibility of abolition of PSW. And I was told, and I read from newspaper, I'm not quite sure, but it is a very definite answer here, that at least temporarily PSW will not be abolished. Is that correct? Okay, I think I see the nodding from the students. So I hope that this is a news that will make our students feel more confident in their competition, in the challenge. So my sincere wish on behalf of my colleagues here, the success of this high-level entrepreneurship challenge. Thank you very much.